So here are some of the filmmakers at the Friends for Friends Film Festival. And these are Hubbard High School students, and the title of their film, The Hardest Thing I've Ever Done. And you took on the issue of vaping.
Yep. Yeah, we did.
Did you have a problem with vaping?
No, I did not.
No, but you saw friends that did. And so does that refer to their problem with quitting it?
Yes.
Tell me more about the film.
Basically, it's about a character named Jack. He's had a vaping problem for we don't even know how long, right? So he starts trying to quit because he notices it's affecting like the people around him. So like his friend Tristan.
You play Tristan in the film?
Yes.
So how are you affected by the vaping?
I personally don't vape, but I think that anyone who does should stop, and if they can't, try to find someone who can help them stop.
And what about you, Gianna? What is your role?
I play Jack's little sister, and it affects me because I witnessed Jack like going through all this hard stuff, and it makes me like feel down and stuff, and as like I'm not important or anything. So it's like it affects me too.
Wow, does the film have resolution?
It does. It does. The character Jack, he stops vaping with the metaphor of the Rubik's Cube. It gets solved at the end because it's all scrambled at the beginning.
Well, more of our talented students are from South Range, and their film is The Pool Party. And it is about cyberbullying. So I'm going to guess that it takes place at a pool party.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Who wants to give me the synopsis?
I guess I will, because it's kind of about me.
Did you get cyberbullied?
I did. I got invited to a pool party by that one. And
did you cyberbully her?
I played into it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and so at this pool party, they pushed me in a pool, actually. So, yeah. That was fun.
And then did they, like, have pictures and made fun of you?
Uh-huh. Yeah. They compared me to, like, the girl from The Ring and, like, Squidward. Yeah.
Wow. And were you at this party?
Yes, I was. I was very mean to her.
You guys were all, like, the mean girls?
I mean, I was the one that pushed her in the pool. But to be
fair,
she did shove cupcakes in my face first, so...
Well, West Branch is represented in the film fest, and Eris is the star of the film Alcohol, The Long Road to Healing. So, Eris, tell me about your involvement in this.
Well, it was a really interesting experience just to be able to, like, see the progress of bringing alive this idea of finding another way to cope and friends helping friends. Like, the whole campaign is just so awesome.
And... do you fall victim to the alcohol as your starring role?
Yeah, my lead character has to find a new way to cope because she chooses to use alcohol, which in her past, her father was an alcoholic, so she was used to like having that environment around. And her mom and her best friend in the film, Liz, actually help her realize that this is a bad idea and that she needs to kind of get her stuff straight.
How much did you enjoy the acting part? I mean, that must have really been interesting, you know, on the film level.
Yeah, there was a couple scenes where my character had to cry, but I cannot cry on command, so we had to use eye drops, so that was interesting. It was definitely nice because Vincent and Jay were both really easy to get along with, and they made the whole process so much smoother. The acting was really fun, and I'd definitely do it again.
Well, Deborah is the liaison for OK Inc., and I really wasn't familiar with this nonprofit. Tell everybody what OK stands for and what you do.
OK Inc., we're a nonprofit organization, and we've been around for 33 years, and our mission is to really challenge young people starting in middle school through high school to do two things: develop healthy relationships and strong character so that they may chase their dreams and have healthy futures and successful futures.
So OK stands for Operation Keepsake.
Yes.
And how do you get into the schools to get involved?
So that's a great question. So we are currently in approximately 120 schools in 11 counties. And our two largest counties are here in Mahoning County and Cuyahoga County near the Cleveland area. And so we provide direct programming. So we actually go into the schools. Schools invite us in, starting in the fifth grade, all the way through high school. And we talk to students about making healthy decisions regarding their relationships. A common theme that we hear from our students is that before they were involved in the project, several have shared with us, you know, I don't think I would ever speak up. I either didn't have the courage or I didn't know what to say. After participating in the project, that's what we see. We see a change in the students who now have that courage. They have that assertiveness that, okay, I'm gonna do something about this. I'm either going to stand up for my friend or I'm going to get them to a trusted adult where the trusted adult can then step in and help them get the help they need.